The tragedy left many questions about the intensity and the volume of the twisters, as well as the unusual timing. For answers, we turn to Howard Bluestein, a professor of meteorology at the University of Oklahoma. Thank you for joining us, Professor. We just saw that map in which all of those reported tornadoes throughout the entire Midwest. How unusual was it to see a wave of storms like this?
Well, it's very unusual to see a wave of storms like this this time of year. This is something that we expect might happen in March or April, but it's extremely unusual to have such a widespread outbreak in the Midwest in November.
Well, let's walk through some of the unusual features here. When was the time of day when these tornadoes struck? We're kind of used to hearing about late afternoon warnings that come, touchdowns of tornadoes, but not an early morning one.
Yes, this was extremely unusual. I believe the storms began around 9 o'clock in the morning, and usually we need to get the sun's heating during the day to get the storms going. But in this case, a very, very powerful storm system came through that lifted the air very, very early, and we didn't need to get to be very warm for the storms to be triggered.
How about the time of year? We just heard the mayor of Washington, Illinois, saying it's not construction season. It's not the time when they're usually building houses. In fact, we're on the lip of winter. How unusual was it for us to see tornadoes like this touch down this time of year?
Well, I think this sets an Illinois record for the number of tornadoes in November. This time of the year, in mid-November, we expect to see snow starting to fall. But instead, the very, very warm air came up from the Gulf of Mexico. The moisture came up from the Gulf of Mexico. And this time of year, it usually doesn't make it that far north.
So do we have any reason to understand, any way of understanding why it did this time?
Well, I think this may have been just one unusual event. A storm system came in on Friday, an upper-level storm system, moved in from Canada into the Pacific Northwest. It tracked across the country, and just before it hit Illinois, when it was over Iowa, it rapidly amplified and intensified. And so I think that was what was mainly responsible for producing this particular outbreak.
I've seen reports of everything from a couple of dozen to 40 to, we just saw, 80 reported tornadoes touching down in that region, all those dozen states. Do we have a count? Is there any way to know what the count is?
We don't have a good count right now yet. There may have been 80 or more reports of tornadoes, but many of those reports were from the same tornado as it moved along a path. So I expect that the National Weather Service will probably go out and do damage surveys, and after the damage surveys, we should know how many tornadoes there actually were.
In terms of intensity and speed and scope, how does this compare to other weather events like this we have seen, especially tornadoes in the Middle West?
Well, this is not one of the most intense outbreaks we've ever seen. There were no EF5 tornadoes, as far as I know, although after the damage survey, it's possible that they may find some evidence of EF5 damage. But one thing that was special about these particular tornadoes was that they were moving very quickly from southwest to northeast. And if they're moving at 50 miles an hour, that adds 50 miles an hour onto whatever its speeds are of the tornado vortex. So that may have also contributed to the intensity of the tornadoes being relatively high.
Even though 8 people sadly died, there was a lot of damage. Were there a lot of alerts that went out in advance that prevented this from having been worse?
This particular event was extremely well forecast by the National Weather Service. The night before, the National Weather Service issued a public statement warning the public of a possible severe weather outbreak. And early in the morning, very early in the morning, a high risk of severe weather was issued. This is the highest level that can be forecast and issued.
Well, it's good that they had some warning at least. Professor Howard Bluestein of the University of Oklahoma, thank you so much.
You're welcome.